Okay, I would say the next topic would be equity and interest rate models. Okay, so we're now talking about a case where I have standard equity dynamics, but on top of that, I want to support stochastic rates. Yeah. Then I can ask myself, is this relevant at all? Okay, what kind of products would be affected by introducing such a model? And okay, you can say there's an implicit equity interest rate exposure. For example, if you do a long-dated option, that can already be enough. But the other example we can discuss here is the auto-callable option. So you have a, I mean, we talked about this. You basically say it's a five-year product, and every year or every half year, you're looking at the spot level. And if the spot level is higher than current spot, you get a coupon. If not, you carry on for the next year, and so on. And the first time you're above the watermark, you're going to get your coupon. And if you it never happens, then at the end, you get maybe the spot back or some other positive curved function of the spot. And these products are going to have a decent, this correlation between interest rates and equity is going to have a decent impact on these. And another one is explicit equity interest rate products. That could be if you say I pay, the payoff depends explicitly on the equity underlying. So you could say a best of equity performance and some LIBOR rate. Yeah. Okay, so let's go back to the auto-callable. One can look at this also in the context of dividends. We've basically seen proportional versus cash dividends are going to have an impact, yeah, because you're conditioning your spot to go up. And now if you're basically conditioning on going up, then it depends on that condition if your dividend is high or low. That's going to have an impact on the price of the auto-callable. So that's one way of looking at it. Here it's now an interest rate story. So again, the payoff is auto-callable. So you've got 7 years in this case. Euro stocks now, and we are checking whether this has ever kind of hit, is trading above the spot. I check this at end of every year, and if so, I pay a coupon which increases through time, so some kind of step-up coupon. And at the end of it, I pay back some kind of payoff, which, I mean, here is specified 100% of notional or 100%, 25% of notion, so it's still an increasing function of spot, but there's other functions available as well. And some of these products also have a continuous barrier on top of that. Okay, now let's look at the correlation between stocks 50 and euro swap rate. Actually happens to be positive here, and I mean that in this period of time. So it's actually it's meaningful to look at that kind of correlation. I mean, what I've seen in practice that people would simply, because they don't know really what that correlation should be, they would price their book and then look at the worst case. Yeah? They would say, I play with correlation from plus 100 to minus 100, and the impact would be fairly limited. What would check in their book, you know, that would be an add-on, let's say, model risk factor. I mean, your model validation team or model risk team might actually ask you to put aside some money for hybrid risk, yeah? So hybrid correlation between rates and equity. So they might ask you to put aside some money for this risk because we don't really know what this correlation is and we don't hedge it. I mean, what I'm talking about, I'm unhedged risk here, yeah? I mean, one can go along and try to hedge this somehow, but you know, maybe it's not worth it or it's not that easy, yeah? So there's basically two main types of equity interest rate hybrids models. So you can do a model on the local vol model, or you can bend towards the kind of stochastic vol models. And I mean, this is a bit similar to this hazard rate. Yeah? You can also say, I assume a local hazard rate or a stochastic hazard rate. But here, okay, the rates process, you would typically pick something very simple. Yeah? I mean, I've seen people doing a LIBOR market model and then trying to have a SMILE model on top of it. But that would be a model which is maybe developed by rates desks. Yeah? So they might say, I want to do long-term rates, long-term FX products, for example. They would then have a very sophisticated rates model, and they just about manage to get a little bit of SMILE in it. But if you're coming from an equity perspective, you might have already your local vol or stochastic vol model set up. And now the question is, how can you sneak in a rates model then you're less concerned about having a sophisticated rates model. You would be happy to do the very simple short rate model, maybe one factor. And that's what I've mostly seen in this context, like think of one factor quasi-check model. Yeah. But of course, more complicated things are possible.